My name is Dr. Sally-Ann Ryder and I'm going to be talking about migraine. Migraine is the most common form of primary headache, that is a headache without any underlying structural pathology. It affects about 7% of the population and most commonly is seen in young adults. It affects women about 3 times more commonly than men and it can come on after puberty. But it tends to get more common as patients get older. So the migraine is usually diagnosed by a neurologist or the GP, and it has a certain specific type of symptoms. There may be a prodrome, which is symptoms that come on before the headache itself, and that might be some intolerance of light or restlessness or fatigue. It's then followed by aura in about 33% of patients, and aura can either be positive, where there's different lights and little rainbows around different objects, or there can be negative aura, which is difficulty finding words or areas of numbness. And then it's followed by the headache. In 40% of patients, the headache is bilateral, and 50% of patients can also get neck pain. Once the diagnosis of migraine has been given, there are either treatments for acute migraine or for chronic migraine if it happens recurrently. Those are slightly different treatments and they are often discussed by the neurologist. In the pain clinic, with patients who come with migraine, we talked about the diagnosis and we helped to offer information and advice as to different types of treatments that might be possible. We often try and ask patients to do a headache diary so we can try and find the triggers that might help with their symptoms. When we look at the triggers, we try and find ways that are trying to help patients to reduce the frequency of their migraine headaches. So we ensure patients have adequate hydration with water. We look at things like stress management and good sleep hygiene and relaxation, such as mindfulness or meditation. And all of these things can help reduce the frequency of headaches. We also look to see if there's anything that might be precipitating the headache from a more lifestyle point of view. Sometimes being overweight or anxiety or depression can make these things worse, and so that's often addressed as well. We also talk about medication overuse headache and trying to explain to patients about trying to avoid taking too many of the painkillers and finding other ways to manage. There are some interventions that we can do in the pain clinic from an injection point of view that might help a few patients with headache. So we tried to put forward a package of measures to try and help patients with their migraine. If you'd like to find out more, come and see us in the pain clinic.